fashion stock. It's always difficult to predict what we can expect, but for sure we are here to get a win. And we know that it will be difficult. I've just told my players that they need to know the difference between two words. One will be difficult, the other will be impossible. And we know we have a difficult task ahead of us, but we also know that it will not be impossible.
Yeah, it's also for me.
Is it working?
Yeah. Yeah, it's a match here. It's the second leg of a Europe League game, and yeah, we want to win the game here. We know that the result last week was not that good for us. I expect an interesting football match, and so it starts 0-0 tomorrow, and we want to win the game, and then we will see how the game develops.
Nils, but it's important for the team to not think about going through and think just about this match.
Yeah, I think it is, and I think it will be. It will not be possible to go on the pitch and then think about whether we have to score 3 goals. We'll not do that. We'll just go to the pitch as normal, and we will try to score a goal, and then we'll have to see how the game will develop from there. And of course, we would like very, very much to go to the playoff round, even though we know that it will also be a difficult match waiting.
What do you think of Brøndby after the different of the first half of the
period? Excuse me, what could you repeat?
What do you think that the team have to do different to win here in Brøndby?
Well, actually, I think our performance in the first match was quite good, except for the last 3 minutes. I think we conceded 2 easy goals, so we have to be better to defend. But I also think that we created a lot of chances in the first match. And can we do that again and then be somewhat more solid in the defense, then we will have a chance.
Dominic. Is there any player in Braga that that impressed you in that first match, special or not?
I think the team they played on a high level. So there was for me not the one guy who decides everything. They have in the midfield some creative guys are good with the ball. With a lot of movement, but in general, for us, it's important to play against the team and not against an individual player. So they have a good team. They showed that last week, they showed their quality. But we also realized that we also have a chance to win against teams like this. So we will see what how their performance is tomorrow, and then I hope we can win the game here.
Yes. Do you think that we can Braga can relax a little bit concerning the result and the fact Sunday they have an important game in the Portuguese Championship?
Well, it's not up to me to decide, but I don't think they will relax at all. I mean, maybe we were a bit relaxed in Finland some weeks ago. We have a lead 4-1, and we lost 2-0. So, no, I don't think any team will take it easy. I think they will. I'm sure they will perform and do whatever they can, but we have to remember they're also up against a strong team.
Nils, you got some injuries up to this game. How has that affected your thoughts on the lineup tomorrow, also looking for Sunday?
Well, I think it's... yeah, of course, it was not what I had hoped for. Injuries is always a bad thing, but it's a part of the game. And of course, now I have two players less in the squad. So, yeah, I have had some considerations about that, but still, I have a lot of good players, strong players in the squad. So we will find a solution.
Skal vi tale lidt på dansk?
Ja, det er
bare godt. Niels, I har talt lidt om, at der skal et mirakel til. Er det helt derop, vi skal? Eller giver den der udekamp, I spillede i Turku, for eksempel, et håb om, at Brakke måske tror, de er videre?
Jeg synes ikke, at jeg vil kalde det et mirakel. Altså, eller en sensation, altså det synes jeg ikke. Men det er klart, at det er op ad bakke, og vi står lidt med ryggen mod muren, om jeg så må sige. Og selvfølgelig vil det være en overraskelse, hvis det kan lade sig gøre for os. Også en pæn overraskelse, men et mirakel, det synes jeg ikke, fordi vi ved godt, at en kampsdynamik er sådan indrettet, at hvis det nu lykkes os at komme foran med et mål, så ved vi godt, hvad der sker med modstanderen lige pludselig. Altså, det så vi med os selv op i fælden. Det første mål er nok det sværeste.
Hvordan skal I så angribe den her kamp? Altså, er det, fordi der er også en vigtig kamp på søndag i Superligaen. Er det stærkeste elve og fuldblåen angreb, eller hvad gør det, du har tanker?
Altså, vi synes, at den her kamp fortjener, at vi giver den fuld skrue og chancen 100%. Det synes vi gør, så jeg har ikke haft overvejelser i forhold til søndagens kamp. Altså, husk på, at holdet og klubben kæmpede hele sidste sæson for at komme i Europa og spille europæiske kampe. Og det synes jeg, man skal vise respekt, både for den præstation, der blev leveret, men også for det ønske, som alle spillere og alle i klubbens fans, hele klubben har, også jeg som træner har, at vi kan gøre det så godt, vi kan i Europa. Og derfor så stiller vi fuld skrue, hvad vi kan her. Det jeg vurderer, der er det bedste. Og så tager vi kampen på søndag mod Aalborg, når vi er færdige i morgen aften med at spille den her kamp. I forhold til den anden del af dit spørgsmål, så skal man ikke forvente, at vi kommer blæsende ud, fordi det tror jeg ikke er den bedste måde at vinde på. Jeg tror, vi skal dele kampen lidt op i nogle perioder, og så sige, kan vi gå til pause med en føring, og en føring til pause, så har vi egentlig et fint udgangspunkt at spille anden halvleg.
Jeg kan huske, at du, da vi spillede op i Finland, brugte Liverpools kamp mod Barcelona som sådan et for jer advarsel til, hvad der kan ske. Nu kan I vel bruge den lige omvendt?
Ja, det kan vi, og vi kan bruge vores egen oplevelse op i Finland til, hvad der kan lade sig gøre. Jeg tror også, at Brøndby for 20-25 år siden spillede en Europa League, eller ikke Europa League, men Europa Cup-kamp hed det vel dengang, og tabte 3-1 på hjemmebane, men vandt 5-0 på udebane, så det kan jo lade sig gøre.